Let's make sure this stuff is working out fine. The sound is coming up. Let's pop up the chat. Spot of tea, how are you doing? How was life? Let me see if that chat popped out or not. Oh, it didn't pop out. What's going on? Show chat. I did the wrong thing. Hi, pop out chat. For some reason, I hit it. Spot of tea. I'm not sure who else is here right now. By the way, spot of tea. It's on its way. The books are on their way. Okay. So you know. They said it's going to take a couple of weeks. At least. It'll probably take longer. Really. Who knows how fast they go. I think the last time I sent your way, it might have taken like a month to get to the UK. So they're on their way. They're on their way. Fun. Boop. There we go. I hope that's working on the chat. Test. Do a little test. Yeah. It comes out. Let's make sure it's coming out on the Twitch stream. Yeah, there it is. Okay, sweet. So we should be okay. We should be live. Brilliant, thank you. The last time they came really quick. I don't mind either way. Okay, awesome, good stuff. Trey, welcome to a live stream. I was just watching your other jam video. I'm passing out when I got the notification. Nice. We're gonna make two this week. We're making the blackberry jam today, and we're gonna make applesauce on Wednesday, 2 days from now. Hey Chicho, Nicholas, hey chat. Was just watching the stream I missed yesterday. I just uploaded it. I decided to let it loose before this started. The liqueur one. It came out good. I'm glad we got the liqueurs done. Curious Devin, how are you doing? Gaming anarchism. I think that's what it says. Gaming anarchism. Gaming anarchism. I was just watching the comic listing on YouTube. I got people watching everywhere. Fun. For some reason, by the way, the video previous to this, which one was it? It's not processing on BitChute. I don't know why. Okay. Listing comic books. What was the other one? The other one was, I've tried 10 times. Like, so many times, different versions. I don't know why. It's weird to me. Because the video, the liqueur video that we uploaded, that we shot yesterday, uploaded fine to BitChute today, right? Oh yeah, the one that's not loading on BitChute is the Superman, Batman, and Go-Go Boy listing comic books on eBay. It's the, I guess, the third or fourth listing comic books on eBay. Okay. Just for those of you who are watching the stuff on BitChute, I know there isn't that many right now. For some reason, it's not loading on properly. They shade you through at the Wonder Moon was hilarious. I didn't like it. Neither did my partner. She reminded me that she started throwing fake popcorn at the screen. Just boo, throwing popcorn. What's the news on the hard drive? Those of you that don't know, last night I was this morning I posted I was transferring over, because the liqueur video that we shot yesterday, what's been uploaded on BitChute and YouTube today is a live stream version, right? The live stream, sort of behind the scenes, I used to call them, right? I did record an HD camera as well, and I wasn't gonna load up the live stream version yet. I usually load up the live stream version after I've edited the HD camera with the lapel mic, the full-on ASMR version, right? Unfortunately, last night when I was transferring the files over from the HD camera, transferred over okay, but it wasn't converting it. So, you know, I loaded the stuff on again, did this, that, you know, you go through the song and dance and do your thing, right? And it still wasn't doing it. So I decided to do my computer automatically does defrags every week. So I decided to defrag. It was only 1% fragmented. did that and tried it again, it didn't work. And then it got stuck. And then I alt control delete, not doing, restart. Lost my, we lost our D drive. And basically we lost the drive that I do all my editing work on, right? Now I have two computers going usually. Usually I have, try to have three at least working, going, that way I'm never down, right? But right now we'll have two computers. This is the live stream computer that you're seeing right now. And my desktop computer is the video processing computer. Now that guy has been going hard, hard for 7 years, okay? So the main drive where I do video editing is kaput. I'm gonna sleep on it, think about it for a week or so, decide what I'm, you know, going to do about it. It's about time that I really kicked up to a higher grade system, make sure everything's being backed up properly and whatnot. So we're not going to be loading on any edited video for a while, okay? Just long intro. The edited video stuff is not going to be loaded on for a while. We're going to continue with the live stream. That should be fine. This computer's only been going hard for about a year now. It should have a little bit of life left in it. So we're going to continue with the live stream. All the live streams we're going to load on now up to BitChute and YouTube. So almost everything will go on. Everything will go on BitChute if we process it. And almost everything will go on YouTube. Until I'm able to figure out what I'm going to do, you know, I'll try to decide in a week or so and then go about it. But the odds are we're not probably going to get into it for a month or a couple of months maybe, right? So ASMR math, comic book readings, some of the other videos that we do with the lapel mic and stuff is gone for now, okay? I'll have to do a full restore somewhere, somehow. That's where we are spotted to. I just figured I'd give you guys an intro because I posted a thing on Discord. Lonely Piggy, hey Chicho, how are you doing? Curious, Devin, I had some questions for you about liqueurs. Do you put the whole fruit in or cut it up or just seeds? Also, what is the ideal temperature to store them? I don't know the ideal temperature. I just say room temperature for the liqueurs. You can do it with the seeds. You can do it for the whole fruit, but you can't really do a whole pear. It's too big, right? So pineapples, I cut up. Berries, just throw them whole in there. Crab apples, they were too big. So crab apple size, I'm cutting, right? Lemons, I'm slicing. So I do cut up the fruit if they're larger fruit. Berries, they go in whole, okay? Cherries, they go in whole. Okay. That's where I am with it. And you can definitely throw in seeds as well, okay? Hey, Chicho, love your kitchen. Thanks, Lions. I love it as well. If you search on Gab Mines or Twitter, you'll see I've taken pictures of what I'm seeing right now, which is sort of open kitchen. It's got windows going on and stuff. It's fun to cook here. I like it. Hey, Chicho, how are you doing? Doing good. Great lasagna. Well, relatively speaking, we lost our main hard drive yesterday, last night. Walsh, how are you doing? Have you looked at the near streaming site Mixer just in case you ever have problems with Twitch? I haven't, Trey. But what I've been thinking, because we lost the hard drive, is I might start, I'm pretty sure I'm going in that direction. We're going to start live streaming on Twitch and YouTube at the same time. Okay. I'm going to look into it, see what I need to do to get that going. Lions, oh, that sucks. Hey, Chicho, super nice. How are you doing? It's okay. It's the nature of the beast, Lion. I mean, seriously, you can't ask more than in the last 7 years. Take a look at what the stuff is. By the way, let me show you the setup because we want to get the thing going, right? Start cooking because this is going to be an easy cook compared to what we did previously with what did we make previously? I forgot. Oh, yeah, the plum jam, right? We made a ton of plum jam. That was a hard cook, right? 5.5 hours we were going. Blackberries, we don't have that much. It was a first going out outing, so it's just going to be one pot, so it's going to be an easy cook, okay? But we should get it going, okay? So let me show you the angles. Okay, here are the two videos, two different angles. We're going to do the cook here and we're going to do the milling here. But before we do the milling, apologies if I'm not going to read the comments for about a few minutes. We want to get this going, right? We're going to do the milling here. So basically when the stuff is done, we pour it in here, we do this. And then this thing just spits out the goodies through here, and the seeds stay on top of this, and then we dump the stuff or keep it and put alcohol. But I don't think I'm gonna do it. I've tried it before. Actually, one of them tasted good yesterday when we did it, so who knows, maybe. But we're not gonna be milling yet. What we wanna do is weigh the stuff, right? So let me bring out our just a little simple, right? And make sure your stovetop is not hot when you put this on it. Yeah. And let's weigh the blackberries. And what we're gonna do, this is pretty high, so you'll see a little bit of it, I guess. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna do a ratio of 1 to 0.75. So 1 pound of blackberries, 0.7 pounds of sugar, right? So basically 75%. And let me show you the blackberries. We got 3 buckets here. Right? Here, actually, let me move this guy over for now. Let me show you the blackberries first. We got basically 3 buckets like this. So these are the buckets, right? These are basically the 5 pound buckets of honey that we used up in the jarring honey video that we had, right? So we've gone through a fair bit of honey. We had a lot of these jars. So we got 3 of these things, right? Let me show them to you. They're good blackberries, and intentionally what I do, I pick, take a look at it, intentionally what I do, I, you know, there's some that I pick the ripe ones for sure. So let me take a look at this. It's like fantastic, right? Really, I popped a few of these in the last few days. And that's still tart. When I'm making jam, blackberry jam, I want there to be tartness, because the tartness makes the jelly harder. Okay, so what I do, I pick the ripe blackberries, right? For sure, you want the blackberry flavor, the sweetness in there, right? Delicious, right? I also pick the blackberries that are also a little red, and parts of it are black, right? More tart. I also pick about this much of the red, the unripe blackberries, if you take a look. Because that again gives it, I think it's pecting and releases, it just makes it harder, okay? The jelly harder. So what we're gonna do is, we're gonna cook basically 2.5 buckets. Half a bucket we're gonna keep for eating, because we like eating it. It's delicious. So what we need to do right now is, because we're gonna weigh this, right? We wanna get a good accurate measurement of what it is that we do. So let's bring these guys over. Bring our measuring, our scale here. Thank you, Joy, everyone. Tony. Bring out. Actually, no, we need a big one. We do need a big one. Big blackberries here. So this is, I'm gonna zero this right now, right? Because when you put this guy on, right? Like this is zeroed right now. Oops, if you see it, right? But if you put this on, you have to compensate for that weight, right? So I need to zero this guy. Let's put it here. Balancing act. There's a little knob at the back that zeroes it. We just move the thing over, right? So let's throw these in. Let's see how many pounds this is. Right? Ooh. Come on. Stuck. This is. Let's throw that in there. Better eat those. And they're juicy, right? Take that. Nice. So this is how many pounds? Mm-hmm. This is about 1.2 kilos, so it's about 2.5 pounds.
Okay.
So those 5 pound buckets of honey hold 2.5 pounds of blackberries.
2.5 pounds.
Yeah. So we're gonna throw this in. So one bucket is about 2.5 pounds, but let me do this gently here. That way we don't lose too much. Ooh, lost a couple. Oh yeah, the bottom ones here. Look at this. This is like squishy. Yes. We lost one more. Let's check it out. This one is 3 pounds. Okay. So 2.5, 3. So that's 5.5 pounds, right? We're gonna throw in these guys. Throw those guys out. And I'm gonna throw in half of this bucket. So let me do this. So we have 5.5 pounds plus another. Another 2 pounds. Let's go 2.5 pounds. My, let's check it out. That's a little bit too much. Let's eat these blackberries. That's a good song. I'm gonna take a little bit back. Let's take a little bit back. And I want the right ones actually. So there's some nice right ones here. But we already measured this, so we can't do that. Let's see, let's see. Okay, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna take one spoon from this because this is the less ripe bucket. I'm going to take one spoon here, pour it in here, and take some of the ripe ones from here and pour it in here. All right? Another spoon here and more ripe here. Approximately balances out, right? That way we have enough to munch on. Okay? So let's see. That should make it 2.5. One more. And one more. Okay, that'll do it. So that's 2.5. Yeah? 2.5. So, look at that. That's full on. Now we're gonna have to keep a close eye on this. You can tell there's a fair bit of red ones here, right? So 2.5 and 5.5. So that's 8 pounds of blackberries, right? So with 8 pounds, ooh, lost one more. This guy, I can put back in the fridge. All right. Let's do this. Let's give this a little wet. Cool. Let's put this one. There's a lid. Let's put this one back in the fridge. If we got this in here, we can do things a little slower, right? I'm gonna kick this up to 5 out of 10, the stovetop, right? I'm gonna add a little bit of water, very little, okay. Like half a cup. just this much water. Even that's a little bit too much, but I don't want the bottom to stick, right? The blackberry is going to give out a fair bit of water itself. So that's that. We're going to put the lid on, and then we're going to measure the sugar. Okay? So where's our lid? Let's put the lid here. Cool. Let's give this a little wash. In general, when I'm doing these types of things, I try to keep the sink clear. Okay. So we don't need to scale anymore. What we do need to do is we're gonna put in some lemons. Okay, so I'm just gonna do the stuff here so you see what it is that I'm doing. And then we're gonna add the sugar. Meteor shower tonight, really? Now I've already washed the lemons, right? The odds are I'm just gonna put the juice from one lemon. Do we need this here? Let's put this here. Let's squeeze this guy. These are pretty juicy lemons. Now what we're going to do, this is just our water cup. I'm just going to pour it in here to de-seed it and de-pulp it to a degree, right? So we got 8 pounds of blackberries. One juicy lemon, the juice of the juicy lemon, make sure the pulp and the whatnot, the seeds aren't going in there. The pulp can go, but the seeds give a bitter taste, so you don't want to put the seeds in there. And this is going to be sweeter, more sugar ratio than what we did for the plums. This one isn't going to be a 5.5 hour session. I don't think so anyway. We're only doing one pot for the, what do you call it? For the plums, we did 6 pots. Right, 6. That's a lot of lemon. Should we put it all in there? That's a fair bit of lemon. Should we put the whole thing in there? It's going to make a tart. Let's put it in. Okay. Now we're going to weigh the sugar. Let's put this guy here. Sugar. So we had 8 pounds of blackberries. We want a ratio of 1 to 3/4, 0.75. Don't do it. Wait, I'm sure that he's not gonna mix a lemon with a black. For sure. Oh, yes. Absolutely mad. Damn, America. You guys win. Put it in. So 8 times 7.5, right? So 2 times 7.5 is 1.5. And we got 4 of those, so we need 6 pounds of sugar. We should be able to put 6 pounds of sugar in there. 6 pounds of sugar in there. Let's do it. I'm ringing the police. Mixing lemon with blackberries. So we need 6 pounds of sugar. 6 pounds of sugar. Let's do it. what it gives us. Hopefully we have enough room. We might have to split this up into two pots. Hopefully not.
This is our bucket of sugar.
Mind you, with the lemon, I added a lot. Usually, maybe only add half or a quarter of that. But I'm on a tart bandwagon right now. Blackberries are the best berries. They're amazing. Blackberries is probably the berries I've eaten the most in my life, by a long shot. Let's see, how much is this going to be? This is going to be 6 pounds of sugar. Let's see what we got. Each one of these is about half a pound, 1 cup. It's going to be a lot of sugar. 2. So that's 1 pound. So if we're going to put 6 pounds, we need 10 more. Wow, that's going to be a fair bit. That seems like a lot to me. So that's 2. Okay. Now I don't need to measure again, right? Because we know what 2 is. 2 is 1 pound, right? So, we can just take these guys. 2 is 1 pound. We wanted 6 pounds, so let's see how much this gives us. So we got 1 pound so far. Oh yeah, there's black sugar here too, or raw cane sugar. So that's going to be 2 pounds. Three pounds of sugar. That's a fair bet. Yes. All the sugar. So that's 3 pounds of sugar. Let's kick it up to 3. That's a lot of sugar. So that's 4 pounds of sugar. Okay? We're going to leave it at 4 pounds. We're not going to kick it up more. Later on, if, you know, we taste it, if we like it, we do more. More sugar going on. My teeth are watching this. Diabetics are running. Funny. Usually wouldn't fill it up this high, right? Because this is gonna take a while. I'm kicking this up to 8. Because what's gonna happen is the blackberry slowly is gonna collapse a little bit. The pockets of air are gonna shrink down, right? Because we need this to be lower. Usually when I'm making jam, I didn't realize the buckets help this much. You don't want this thing to be all the way to the rim. You want it to be halfway to 3/4 of the way max, right? So we want this going down. Let's put this guy. Sorry about that sound. Kick this up. Let's pick it up. Put the lid up. Now that we got this thing going, We got a couple of other things to do, but we're in holding pattern, basically, right? What I'm going to do is, here. Oh yeah, this thing's going. We do have to prep the lids as well, right? Just don't add yeast, you don't know. But this thing, you gotta wash jam carefully. When this thing starts cooking up, it can go spill over. Like big time. And it's just a mess, right? Blackberry bouncing around the pan in sugar. Shock. Someone just singing. Oh, I think teacher was cooking a mound of sugar with a few blackberries sticking out. It's like liqueurs, but Sugar flavored blackberry. One or two more flakes. That's my usual breakfast. Hey guys, this is Chicho. Welcome to my channel. Today we're making a grand sacrifice to the sugar gods. Too funny, too funny, man. Too funny. Sally on my keto week. The same thing next week. Oh no! No blackberry jam for you, Martin. Chicho looking outside. Hey kid, come get some sugar. Too funny. Okay, man, I gotta put the water in. You guys are making me crack up hard. That's so funny. We're gonna do a double pot system for the lids, right? Boil water, and the lids in here, and then let it sit. So, what do you call it? It sterilizes, right? So let's do this. Let's kick this up. Let's add water. More sugar with their blackberries, I guess. Yeah. This chat today, spotted you laughing. Let's make sure this isn't gonna get too much water. No, it's good. Let's put the lid on here. Now, what I'm gonna do is, kick off this guy too in the other element. I'm just gonna heat this up as well. That way the water's boiling when we put the lids in, so we know they're gonna be sterilized. Hey Chicho, Germato, how are you doing? Welcome to another live stream. Breaking news, Canada runs out of sugar. Fun infused fire. Oh, I gotta turn down the tea a little bit. I'm drinking matcha tea right now. I think I had my fill of liqueur yesterday. Breaking. Oh, this thing's boiling away. With these flat top stuff, I don't know what you call it when it's not, when there's water under the pans, it starts kicking up hot. It gives it, it does this, right? It's just the water. There's a word for it in chemistry where the water bubbles are surfing on top of a very hot surface. It's super cool, actually. We used to do that, or we did a little bit of that in school, right? And all you gotta do is just lift it up, and the water evaporates. Bearded wizard jacked up on my runs rampant around Canada, stealing sugar from every store he can find. Funny, she's just gonna make a panini. Actually, that would be very good. That would be very good. A little bit of tartness. Good. You can hear it right now. And it's already, I don't know if you can tell right now, it's already sunk down a little bit, right? Like it's not all the way to the top, maxed out. The sugar god responds to your I might have added a little too much sugar. We'll see, we'll see. But this blackberry was going to be tart. So if I added too much sugar, what we've ended up doing is, I don't want to tap, it's going to be a little loud. Our plum jam was very tart, not too sweet. And this one's going to be crazy sweet. So what we can do for our pastries, if you want to make something that's the right amount, you mix a little bit of blackberry, you mix a little bit of plums, and you layer the pastries with it, and Amazing stuff, amazing stuff. Add more lemon to balance the sugar. Lasagna. You might have. Never would have guessed it. Oh, I got it. Fun. Fun. Let's see, is this guy doing it? Yeah, this guy's going. This guy's going. That's good. And then these are the lids, right? These are guys. We're gonna put them. Okay. Add a little bit of yeast. Not burn on the sides of the pot. It's not gonna burn because it's it is hot, but it's not that hot. Okay. And I'm not gonna keep it at this temperature the whole time. I'm just kicking it up. Just to get it going nicely. Like you can see it, it's already liquefying, right? Take a look. So I just want it to liquefy. Alright? You can see it coming up. Once it liquefies, then I'm gonna kick it down a notch. Right? Which is now. So I'm kicking it down to, and you can smell the blackberries now. Right? Like the cook. So I'm kicking it down to 5 now, but I'm gonna start keeping a really close eye on this. Okay. Ideally what I should do, still okay for a few more minutes. I'm gonna put a little timer on this. Timer, let's say 4 minutes. Okay. Kick it out 3 times. Yet. The kick one, I guess not. Casey's, I'm pretty sure, is on it. Okay, that's good. Is this guy boiling? That's good. Okay. Down. We're gonna kick it down. Yes, I was gonna say kick, but I pulled it back. I'm gonna turn that down a little bit too. Right. Nice. Okay, we're gonna do our double pot right now. Let the stuff sterilize. I'm turning this guy off, this element off. I'm putting this element. The one out here. Actually, let me show it to you here what I'm gonna do. That way you guys know. So that's boiling, right? So all I'm gonna do is just take this guy and put this guy in there. Be careful, steam burns, right? And I'm gonna take this off and just pour these guys, right, in here. And they don't all have to be brand new. One of them you saw was used, right? And what I can do is just close this off. Right? And I'm gonna let this sit and it's gonna sterilize, right? But I'm gonna put it on the other element. Okay. Ooh, it's gonna boil. And you have to be careful with it because once you move it there, because it was hot, it's boiling, bubbling, splattering, right? I don't want it boiling all the time. Once it boils, once it's enough, right? So I'm just kicking it down to like 2 out of 10. And let's take a look at this. Nice. We haven't made blackberry jam for a while. For like 3 years now or so. Kick, Jesus. Casey took care of it. Probably easier to abbreviate the SBS. What's the SBS? Blah, 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 blah. All the sound effects are coming out. Cool. This is perfect. So we need to cook this. Let's cook it up. This is where we've got to be really careful with this, okay? I'm gonna kick it up to like a 7. But to make sure it's not gonna spill over, I'm gonna leave the lid open a little bit, okay? It's not gonna prevent it from spilling over if you don't watch it, but it's gonna give you like an extra second, right? To catch it if you have your eye on it, if it's coming up, okay? Blackberry, actually jam in general, spills over fairly rapidly, okay? Speedy Gonzales, jeez. You forgot to add sugar to the water. Too funny. To the lids.
What I'm gonna do is, you guys got me questioning my recipe here, man. I'm gonna taste the blackberry. With a little spoon, right? Let's mix this up a little bit.
Like the blackberry gives out a lot of water, right? Let's mix it up. Let's see what this is gonna taste like. Chicho likes.
Hey kids, not to be confused with kids. What's with all the craziness, Martin says. Wait, Chicho.
We're just going to say, it's crazy how much water is in there. Yeah, it gives out a lot of water. Big time. Seven. It's a madhouse. Yeah. The water to sugar ratio is way off.
Well, how are you doing? Welcome back.
Okay, I'm gonna turn. Actually, before we turn this off, I want to show you this. Here's the mill. Actually, I showed you the mill already. Is this hot? It is hot. So I'm not gonna put this here right now. I don't want it to be hot right now. So what we're gonna do is, as you can tell, I closed the lid again because it's not curdling yet. I want to get it to a curdling stage. Let me turn off this video. Oh, wrong one. Let's turn off this video. Because we're not going to need it for a bit. You're just...
That virtually no sugar though. Welsh has missed all the insanity.
I was, man, yesterday.
That was a lot of liqueur I sampled yesterday. What are we making here?
We're making blackberry jam. Blackberry that we picked a few days ago. Okay. And that's what it is. I do have this guy that once it gets going, I'm gonna start mixing a little bit. And you do wanna get the bottom as well so the bottom doesn't stick to the pot, right?
Sugar.
Police going to show up at the door. We got a call from some mother. Heard a lot of kicking covering residents.
Food abuse is a second degree in this arena. You know what? I don't have too much hope in law enforcement doing the right thing.
Damn. Lads, I lost my phone. Lions, you lost your phone. What? Kick. Great lasagna. Subscribe. Lasagna, thank you very much for the Twitch Prime sub. This stream is so sweet. The puns, the jokes are phenomenal. Hilarious, man.
Police are going to roll up looking for Canada sugar supply.
Yeah, I think, is this from Canada? This is cane sugar. So I don't think it's from Canada. Mind you, we're growing a lot of sugar in BC, by the way. One of the things, what is the Canadian FDA? I forget what it's called, Canadian food something? One thing that's happening in BC, we're growing a lot of sugar. Because what happened in Canada, they took off the monopoly powers of major breweries. So they allowed local distillers to be set up across Canada. And every province sort of manages the alcohol rules and regulations independently, right? So what they did, I'm just kicking up the temperature on the water a little bit. I do want it to be steaming for the lids, okay? So what British Columbia did, it basically said if Canadian food something you can set up a distillery, you can what do you call it? Distill alcohol, spirits in British Columbia, but you have to source your sugar from BC. So there are distilleries set up locally that are using either honey for their sugar, or they're using beets for their sugar, and I think some are using corn. I'm not 100% sure on that, but beets and honey I know for sure. And it's not the honey you eat, it's the scrapings and stuff like this that you can't really sell on a consumer level, which is cool. Which is cool. Cibo matto, now sugar water. Got to know your sugar. You've got to know your sugar. I'm not familiar with the alcohol law here in Ireland. Alcohol is the lions. Oh my God. Ireland, you guys drink a lot. Oof. A lot. Back in 1998 when I was there, you drank a lot. Now, foam is good. That's what we want. You can see the steam coming up. So there was no steam when I didn't mix it because there's a temperature difference between the bottom and the top, right? So once you're ready, once you think it's cooking up enough, right? You can see the steam, right? Give it a mix. And this is when it starts getting dangerous. This is when it can spill over. So let me move this guy over. Move this guy over. I'm still gonna leave the lid on. I'm gonna leave this at 7, but I'm gonna be checking it on a really regular basis right now. Tell us the story of your 1998 Ironman trip. Would you like to hear? For sure. Looks awesome. This looks pretty good. Sugar industry is the biggest polluter where I live. Very powerful in the local government. Are they? The sugar industry, really? Listen to some system of a down stream sugar. Nice. Oh, I have a Guinness specially sat in the pub next to the fire with this raining outside. Nice. 98. Just after we stopped bombing each other. Yeah, there were flare ups back then, Lions. There was a little bit of flare ups back then. Just to let you know the story, in 98, I went to Europe, backpacking in Europe. Just to trek around. Started off in Barcelona, I went to Ibiza, southern Spain, Greece, and a whole bunch of other places, right? And I had a Euro pass, but the UK didn't accept the Euro pass back then. I don't know if they do now or not, or even there is such a thing called a Euro pass. Euro pass was something that you could use for trains. You could travel anywhere that trains went in Europe. The UK didn't accept it, right? So from France, I believe, I flew to Ireland. I went to Dublin. And interesting times, interesting times. One thing I can tell you about the Irish, and I got my Irish story doesn't begin in 98. My Irish story begins in 1984 or so, actually before then. But 1984 really begins me and my relationship with the Irish. Me trying to understand what was going on in that region, right? And but we'll skip a couple of decades, 15 years or so, and we'll go to 98. So I went to Ireland, and I didn't know what to expect. And this was towards the kicking up to 8. I just want to get a kirkling, right? Because we do need to cook it up, cook it up. Sugar war started. Chicho versus the Irish. Look up the companies, U.S. Sugar Corporations and Florida Crystals. So U.S. Sugar Corporation and Florida Crystals. Cool. Of course. They deserved it after 800 years. I did sometimes strapping back years of massacring us. Yeah. And I learned a little bit of my history, but Irish history is very complex, very complex. But basically, my first day in Ireland, I went to a, what do you call it? I haven't done it for so long, I forgot. Where backpackers go. What are they called? Like a big dorm where you can rent a bed with your stuff. I forget what they're called. So I went to one of those places, got my bed, and hostel. I went to a hostel, right? So I went to a hostel in Dublin, and I wanted to check out what Ireland was like. So first thing I did was go to the pub. So checked into the hostel, went to the pub, right? I wanted to get a Guinness. I wanted to grab a drink, a Kilkenny and a Guinness in Ireland, right? Not that I support the Guinness family and stuff, because there's a lot of wacko history there as well. But back then, I wanted to have a Guinness and a Kilkenny in Ireland, right? So I went and sat down at the pub, and I sat at the bar. And I didn't know anyone. I was traveling alone in Ireland, or all of Europe, really. I hooked up with people and stuff. And back then, the Armenian earthquake had recently happened, I believe, or happened a few years before and stuff. And the news was showing on the television screen. And it was a local Irish news station. I don't know what it was. It could have been the only Irish news station, but it was an Irish news station, right? And then they started talking about the Armenian stuff, and they started covering history of Armenia. And I'm from Canada, and I've never seen any mainstream news sources cover anything about Armenia in the 1980s, right? Like, not even close, not even close. So, and I listened to more news, and there were intelligent news, right? Like, really, like, they're covering stuff that you would have never seen in Canada or the United States. I don't know about the rest of the places, right? So I drank my Guinness, one, two, and there was an older guy sitting beside me, and I turned to him, I said, what news station is this? And the guy goes, it's our local news station. I said, this is pretty heavy news. Like, they cover a lot of international news. I'm from Canada, he knew I wasn't from Ireland, right? He goes, oh, where are you from? I'm from Canada. So the conversation went that it's the Irish, long story short, the Irish were the most politically aware nationality, country that I went to, traveled in. It was crazy. They knew politics about Africa, Middle East, Asia, Eastern, like everywhere, right? It blew me away. It blew me away, right? So I had a deep, long conversation with this older gentleman. He must have been like in his 60s, like retired guy. I don't know what retirement is Ireland, but in Canada, he would have been retired. So he filled me in. He told me a lot about what was going on and all this stuff. And the Irish Accord was just, the Good Friday Accord, I believe, was just recently signed. Okay. And why do you suppose that is? The Irish being the most politically aware. The reason it is because the British Empire, one of the first nations, peoples that it tried to commit genocide on and take over that land was the Irish, with the potato famines and just it wasn't even a famine, they were just taking out the food. So one thing I found out was, like, you gotta give respect where respect is due. The British, the Good Friday Agreement, yeah, is bullshit, most likely, right? I knew a lot more before Alliance, right? But it was a few months after the Good Friday Agreement that I was there, right? So the reason that they're politically aware is because they have been they were under occupation for centuries. There was another nation trying to commit genocide on them, get rid of them, right? It's crazy. Oh, look at the phone. That's what we want. Okay. Take a look. It's going to go bloop. Can you see it growing? Bloop, bloop. Nice. Excellent, excellent. That's exactly what we want. A little bit there. Okay, we're gonna give it a spin. And we're gonna kick it down to a five. Okay. So they had to be politically aware. So after partying in Dublin, and I went to Cork as well. Cork was phenomenal. I went to Belfast. I wanted to go to Belfast, see what it's all about. And when I went to Belfast, there was a little bit of flare-up during that period in Belfast. There were a couple of, I don't know if there were bombings, but there were flare-ups. Like I went to, one of the things I did in Belfast, I went to a pub, a bar, and I was participating in the festivities and stuff like this. I started talking with people and whatnot, and alcohol being what it is, you know, I got real, I got close to a couple, and there was a couple, and there was a two girls and a guy, and we were partying and stuff like this, and we came out of the pub. And we came out of the pub, and there was a car burning outside, and the police were full out, full on, and there's stuff going on. And me, I like talking politics, and all of a sudden it occurred to me that, you know, forgive me, Lions and all the Irish, I couldn't tell the difference between the Protestants and the Catholics. I couldn't tell the difference between the, well, let's put it that way, the Protestants and the Catholic, the two factions in Northern Ireland, right? So that must be how a lot of people from Western world, when they travel to different parts of the world, especially military, and because one of the things you heard regarding the Middle East is the soldiers, the kids that went there from Canada, UK, and stuff like this, they couldn't tell the difference between good guys and bad guys, right? Or this faction and that faction, or Afghanistan, or wherever they go to. And that's the way I felt when I came out of the pub with this couple and this girl. I didn't know which faction they were. So I stayed with them a little bit, but I had said certain things that I didn't know if it was gonna go over well, if I was being played or whatnot. So we parted ways. And one of the things I did in Belfast that I really wanted to do, I was staying at the hostel, and it was the time when Lock, Stock, and Two Smoking Barrels had come out, because I went to the theater to watch it and pissed myself laughing. It was so funny. But one of the things I did in, I wanted to do in Belfast is walk around Belfast and take pictures of the murals. And people told me not to do it because you don't know where you're going and stuff like this, and I didn't care. So it was in the 1980s. People are talking, and what I ended up doing was putting on my walking shoes, little dingy camera I had, and I walked around Belfast everywhere, near prisons and places that looked a little shady, train tracks, all over the place, and I took pictures of murals. And if you do a search for Chicho Ireland murals, let me find you see if I can find you Chicho. I think I called it taking a walk in Belfast, Ireland murals. Let's see if it shows up. Graffiti and murals from Northern Ireland. Here we go. Here's the link, and here are the pictures that I took. Some of the pictures. It's not all the pictures. Let me bring up the chat. Here, check out this. So those are some of the pictures I took during that trip. Okay. It was interesting. For 2 days, I just walked around and took pictures and checked out Belfast. Occupation was that bad. The British occupation, from what I understand, was horrendous. We don't get taught that. History in the States, no. Or in Canada. We never got taught it in Canada either. being a British Israeli, I'm sure we'll have some interesting news and all this. Yeah, there must be. We got people from the UK and Ireland watching this, so there's going to be interesting conversations. I think later on, at some point, I might do a read on this chat. The claim no religion. It was really bad during the 17s and 18s. Lions, when was the potato famine? Famine, if you want to call it famine. It wasn't really a famine. It was a planned starvation, right? From what I know. As Irish American Catholic family at that. Ooh, look at that. We caught it in time. See a bubbly? Nice. And you want to scrape the bottom of this thing, okay? Because you don't want the jam to stick to the bottom. You don't want it to burn. And we're going to start harvesting some foam. I'm leaving the gap wider, okay? A little bit wider. Let's harvest some foam. Harvest it. I do want to harvest it something that the foam stays. It doesn't come down too much. Well, I might harvest it in two bowls. We'll see. Oh. I gotta be careful with this lid because it slips and closes every now and then. And right now, I got the temperature around 5.5, 5.5 out of 7. It was around the turn of the century. I'm not sure. It was during the 16 and 17s, if I remember correctly. Okay. Can you fact check? Yeah, fact check would be amazing. I scrape off some of the foam. And I'm waiting for this almond to cool down a little bit. Foamy goodness. This foam is phenomenal. Okay, I need to give it a stir. Let's put this here. Oh, look at this. We need to give it a stir. Kick up the temperature of the water where the lids are. Okay. Now try not to get any of the seeds, just the foam. I do want this jam to be more solid. Let's put this guy here. Where are we gonna put our lid? Okay, we're gonna do this with the lid. Let's put this guy here. Put the lid here. Just put it here. Okay. This guy. Nice color to it, eh? Beautiful color. Let's get the foam. Take out the foam. This is curdling faster and faster now. Nice. And this is sitting at Yeah, still five. Sitting around five. Being pure, confident, like their authority being challenged. They always respond with extreme violence and cruelty. Yeah. One thing I found out, the reason that there's so many Irish pubs around the world is because of the genocide being perpetrated on them, or the attempted genocide. So a lot of Irish fled or went to different countries, and a lot of the Irish pubs, Niles, you correct me on this, for sure correct me on this, they became hubs for the resistance, where a lot of people communicated and stuff. It was interesting. I need to read up on my history again for Ireland. I'm gonna give it a taste again. This little spoon. Now be careful tasting this. This is gonna be crazy hot, right? So I'm not gonna taste it right now. I'm gonna put it here and let it cool down. Nice. Buff Monster, how are you doing? Also, in retaliation to the 1916 Rising, a small rebellion where Dublin was shortly occupied by the Irish rebels, the British leveled most of the city with worship. Wow, crazy. Mastering was a blast. Still have some. And he saw me drinking. So I'm watching. Boy, what are we doing? Nice, sweet. I'm glad we didn't add more. Let's give this a whirl. If I feel the bottom sticking at all, I'm gonna kick it down. Don't want to burn the bottom of this. How many pounds of sugar do we have? We added 4 pounds, right? 4 pounds? I forgot. So it was 8 pounds of blackberries. So it was a 1 to 2 ratio, really, or 2 to 1 ratio, right? All humans, like 1% of every race ethnically at this point. Let's taste the foam. Check it out. See this? And it stays solid, which is really good. And at the bottom of it, there'll be some of the jam, right? Look at that. Yeah. Yeah. Very, very good. Delicious. Delicious. Let's keep this a little white. Some goes for all British Irish. You meet some Yank who goes, yeah, in English. And you say, cool. Where did my book? Oh, I lost that. Fast conversations. Gems looking unreal. Yeah. Great color. That's one of the things about blackberry. The color of the jam is phenomenal. You take a little bit of this and sour cream and bread, sourdough bread, flatbread. With feta cheese. So good, so good. I mean, the color of this thing is amazing. And then what you do after you know, when you start jarring and stuff like this. Oh yeah, I should show you this as well. I forgot about the oven. So we have the jars in the oven as before, right? I didn't take pictures of this. But basically, I got two trays like this of jars. So we're gonna kick up the temperature on the oven right now, bake. And we're gonna call it, we're gonna kick it up to, actually 350 is good. Okay, so you're gonna hear the fan kick in. Apologies, but it's the way it works. So we're gonna kick up the temperature on the jars to sterilize them, to heat them up. And then what we end up doing is, as before, we're gonna mill this. We haven't done the milling yet. We did it with the crab apples, not live stream. So we're gonna mill this here and then bring the stuff over and start jarring, okay? And you'll be able to see the jarring over here. We don't have to set it up in the middle. Okay. St. Patrick's Day, from what I understand, not too many people, hardcore Irish, I've celebrated it, but from what I understand, it's not that huge in Ireland, is it? Lions? How many jars you have in your house? A lot. I even bought more yesterday. The big ones we did for the liqueur, I had a 6-pack of those, and I bought an extra dozen of the 500 ml. So we're gonna do mainly 500 ml. I got some 250 ml as well. It's good to have food in the house, man. If you can do your own jarring and canning and stuff like this, it's a really good way to make sure you have food in the house. It's important, right? It's not you, my brother. Just a topic. Hard as Northern Ireland is very political, and as I say, I've had family who lost their life, blah, blah, over it. But you did no wrong, brother. You are just talking and being passionate. Just a rough subject for me. I appreciate it. Okay. Awesome, the conversation. Conversations and trusting. Communication is where it's at, man. Communication is where it's at. Really, Jam, the most inoffensive common thread that brings all of us together. Yeah, curious Devin. What a great thing. Food and drink. What a great thing. First he steals can of sugar supply, then he darkens the jar supply. Like a lot of jars. Like this thing full of jars. This guy. Right? I don't know if you can see it. We got jars in here. Like mint. Jarring mint. Liqueurs. Jams. Kombucha we're going to start making again. Pickles. It's good to have food in the house. Still very liquidy. We shouldn't have, we added the half a cup of water because we don't want the bottom of the clam to stick. But we added half a cup of lemon juice, basically a third, right? So that could have done. We should have added like a quarter of a cup. We just have to reduce it now, let it curdle away. We have St. Patrick's Day in Wales. Lots of the fotis and leeks. Forget the police. We need Mulder and Scully. X-Files. We all want to be loved. As soon as that message gets around the world, We can all work together for peace on earth. Curious Devin, 100% agreed. Love and understanding. Understanding is really important. I think one of the main problems with our relationships is lack of understanding. You can see it in families, right? There's lots of love there, but then when communication breaks down, when someone thinks that they're not understood, then things start going a little haywire. the foam over here. So I don't accidentally muck it up. Actually, let's put it over here so we don't accidentally muck it up. That's good foam. Let me show you my jar collection. There's a reason peace talks often include banquets. It's hard to hate someone when you sit and eat with them. Ah, that's a great point, Nicholas. That's a great point. That's a great point. I never thought about that. St. David's Day. Dophidus. Or a flower. Wow, okay. Leeks are a type of onion. Oh, leeks. Oh, yeah, leeks. Okay. No peace without war, though. I don't know. I usually end my messages with peace if I'm emailing people. So I'm not necessarily in war with them. I just wish. Maybe generically it means war. Love that idea for a video. What is that idea? Oh, the jar collection. Maybe, I don't know. You should see this. Rock collection. Yeah, rock collection. Rock. It's not rocks, Martin. It's minerals. Crystals. That's from Breaking Bad. We used to have biggest leek competition in the primary school. Really? Leek soup is amazing. Leek soup is so good. So fucking Welsh, I love it. Yeah, this thing is beautiful. Look at that. Look at that. And we're gonna be milling this. So basically, we've cooked it down where there's barely, there's still some chunks of blackberry. We're gonna cook it down to, you know, it's not all gonna break down, but a lot of it is broken down into little, like the seeds, right? We still got a ways to go. What we can do right now is actually start milling it. So let's start doing the milling process. And I have another pot here that as soon as we mill, like this pot is small, right? We're gonna mill enough in here to get like half and then pour it into the other pot. And then, sorry about that. And then we're gonna transfer, right? Actually, we don't need the lid. Let's put the lid over here. We do need this guy. And I'm gonna turn on this. This guy over here, okay, and you're gonna see it here. Basically what I do is I pour this stuff here, right? Unfortunately we get some on the thing, but that's okay. And it's easier to mill when it's hot. Can you hear the blackberry, the liquid going down? So the filter's holding up the... Now what we do is, we don't want to lose this guy. Now what I'm going to do is, this can get messy, so we're going to wear our apron. And who says high school didn't give you anything useful? This is an apron I made in grade 8.
Sorry about the noise. I'll try to keep it down, okay?
And then what you do is you go in the other direction and it picks it all up. And you, with a spoon, you just take it out and dump it into a bowl. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to kick down this element to a 2 for now.
I need to transfer this stuff into a bowl. So let's bring it here. Let me put it in the clear one so you guys see what it's going to look like.
And the reason why I was like, man, I want to keep using this stuff because it still has flavor in it. Get a little bit of vodka and pour put this in a jar, pour vodka on it, and then filter it out. Just let it sit for a few hours and filter it out because it should pick up the flavor quite nicely. Now you don't have to de-seed it, but there are people that don't like it with the seeds. I'm getting a little bit of splatter. I gotta go a little slower. Let's kick this down to 1. Need it to be steamed. And then every now and then you gotta go like this to clear up the holes. And then you can go in the right direction. Get as much of the goodies out as possible, right? That's enough. gonna transfer the stuff over because this is pretty full.
So we need a plate. And by the way, usually the milling you don't do on the stovetop. I'm doing it here because we've got the camera set up. Usually you're doing the milling in the sink. That way the splatter doesn't go everywhere, right? So I'm just gonna move this guy here. Let's put this guy here, put that guy there. I'm gonna move this guy over. I'm gonna bring this guy. Put this guy here, and I'm gonna pour the jam in there. I'm gonna pour it slowly. Actually, I'm gonna put the lid down. Because if there's any spillage, I wanna make sure I catch it. If there's any, there will be dripping. I don't want it to go in the bottom, right? Because that way I'm putting it on the top again. So we don't want it to stick to the countertop or the stovetop. Right? Give it a wipe. See? Right. So it came through here. You just give it a wipe and you're good to go again. Let's just put this guy here, bring our mini back, and keep on going. And what I'm doing right now is I'm keeping the temperature on this one at a 1. This is the buzzer going off telling us that the jar's at a 350 degrees, right? Okay. Now before we do anything else, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to take a little bit of the jam. And I'm gonna put it in the freezer. And we're gonna put it in the freezer for a few minutes. I want another. Yes. We're gonna put it in the freezer for a few minutes just to see how fast it hardens. Okay? Because if it hardens, then we know the jam is ready. If it stays liquid for, you know, after like 5-10 minutes, then we're gonna reduce it a little bit more. And we're gonna continue with our milling while that thing is cooling down. After a certain point, just gets stuck, right? So, grab it. This is how much we got so far. For eBay, I thought about putting up some of these jams on eBay, but I looked up the rules and regulations, and they said you have to have a licensed kitchen. This is a Chicho kitchen, so it's not gonna work. Right. I thought it'd be fun to, when we do cookings from now on, just put them on eBay, but we might do something else with it. We might do an open auction. That's what some people have been mentioning, that for the comic books, instead of listening on eBay, where you're getting fees up the yin yang and stuff through PayPal and whatnot, just do open auctions
So at some point we'll kick that in as well. And what we can do is, for our cooks, we can do as well. Right? I think that'd be fun. A long time ago when we made the crab apples, I sent a couple of jars to people. I would kill for some cheese. Thanks so much. Seriously. Maybe we do. Maybe we do. Next week, maybe we do. We'll see. Let's make the applesauce. See what the applesauce is like. And maybe we do something along those lines. I do need to raise some money. I gotta replace the hardcore system. We had our main desktop computer go down, and it's down. Half of it is down anyway. The operating system stuff is going okay, but that's been cranking it as well. I killed the hard, what do you call it? The SSD drive a few years ago. So this is the second SSD drive that I'm going through with the desktop. So it's time for, I think for the next upgrade, I do want to kick it up pretty heavy. There's a few things that I need to do, especially regarding the mathematics. I want to, now give this, don't forget about this, give this a spin as well. So you're making sure that the jam is not sticking to the bottom here. We got it at 1, so it shouldn't stick. But because there's a fair bit of sugar there, you never know. Pour some marmalade on. What? This will burn you, man. You don't want that. Marmalade is made with only citrus fruits and contains the peel. Oh, really? Is that what it is, Nicholas? That's what's defined as marmalade? That's cool. I didn't know that. Explains a lot. Send some jam as well as that. Go-Go Boys on its way. Go-Go Boys on its way. Can't send jam and comic books in the same package. Well, you could, I guess, but not a good idea. Liqueurs with these pulps. The amount of jam we're going to get out of this is not very much relative to the, oh, take a look at this. Nice, that looks good. Okay, let me pour this in here. It's about 3/4 full. Basically, what we want to do is make sure it's like room temperature, right? Very nice. It's still fairly liquidy, right? Not that much, but I'm going to reduce it a little. So I'm kicking this guy up to 2. And we're going to I want to get it to a level where it's going to steam.
At least I can eat.
Oh, I didn't bring any bread out. I do have a little bit. Yeah. I should make some... I have some sourdough bread in the freezer. I should be toasting that up. But the sound of the toaster going click, 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 click. Now, I don't want the bread near the jam because... That's very good. And it is sweet. I'm very happy that we didn't do more, right? More sugar. We should have probably done for the 4 pounds, for the 8 pounds of blackberries, I think the ideal sweetness would have been 3 pounds of sugar. And then scraping the stuff off the main and the other one, main pots. Very delicious. Okay, that's full enough. Gotta do this slow. I'm gonna kick the oven down to 25. See a single one. That's one thing that blew me about Ireland. There's every pub had someone like live singers going. It was amazing. I didn't see that anywhere else. Not every pub, but every club I went to. And this is one of the reasons we didn't do the milling for the plums, right? Because it takes a fair bit of time to do. has a single lot going on. Awesome. Awesome. Clear, yeah. So bring this guy over. Look at that. Pretty good. Pretty good. It is on the sweet side. I would do it less sugar. Now I'm gonna give, because I don't want any seeds coming in this, so let me make sure there's no seeds in this. Okay. Now we can put this guy in here. Kick this up to a 3. Okay. This guy's basically done. We'll pour it in here. I need a spatula. the goodness out there. This guy here. We can give this one a spin. Yes. Let's give this one. Get all the juice out of this. This is what we ended up getting. That was 8 pounds of blackberries. Cool. See you, Curious Devin. Hope you have a fantastic Monday. We're done with the mill. So the mill, we're just gonna put on the side. We'll take care of it. And we're going to pour the rest of this in here. I'm just going to do it this way, that way. There's no splatter to system. Okay. Let's bring another spatula. I'm gonna pour this into our plate. Where is our plate? Oh, it's right there. I'm gonna put it in the freezer. Okay, and see how solid it gets. Give the spatula a lick. Okay, now this guy will put water. Just gonna need to clear up the sink, right? Now, we're gonna kick this up. I'm gonna kick this up to a 4, okay? And we still need to keep a pretty close eye on it. We don't want it curdling anymore, right? I just want it to be steaming a little bit. We'll see where it goes. The curdle is gonna make a splatter all over the place, so I don't wanna do that. But there is one thing I want to do. Look at this. I want to scrape some of that. Chichonia. Is that my language? Oh, it's already hardening up. Take a look. Oh, this we're gonna put in the freezer. before we do that, let's put this guy here. Very sweet. Very sweet. Definitely, I would have put 1 pound less sugar. Okay. Give this a mix. And this guy, you won't be able to scrape it off. If I use a knife, I'm going to scratch the pot. I don't want to scratch the pot. Let's check it out. Yeah, it's not going to work. It's already solidified there. So I'm just going to pour hot water on top of this. This is really good.
Use a spatula to wash through.
Got the pot boiling a little bit.
Bubbling, crackling.
What's a gurgle? I don't know. I call the gurgle. Is that not a real word? Crazy. The words, I think they're words that they're not words. So be it.
Like this over here. We don't need the lemon. Let's put this guy in the fridge for now too. Make some room. We've got jars coming out.
A lot of this cleanup I would generally do as I'm going, right? That's me. Of little splatter marks of the jam on the stove, so I'm just going to give these a wipe. Clean up our area a little bit. Okay. Because we're going to put hot jars on here. This grand high crickler. Oh, funny. Funny. Okay, we're gonna set this up. Now, what I'm gonna do is, because the jars are gonna be hot, I'm gonna lay down a couple of these guys. You know what? I'm gonna lay down the cutting board and then put this on top, because I don't want the countertop. It's not wood, it's not. It's, I don't know what it is. So we're going to do this. And I'm going to leave this on top of it. What I'm also going to do, I'm going to get another sheet, not another sheet, but another towel to put on top of the jars once we put the jars over there, because I don't want them cracking during the cooling process.
Okay.
The other thing we need to do is I need to set something up here where I can transfer, start jarring, right? Make sure you keep an eye on this. You don't want this to blow over and spill.
Let's put the wood on here.
Okay. We'll do it with the wood. Cool. That should be okay. We're putting the hot. Beautiful color, beautiful, and it's getting a little bit thicker. Look at that. Nice. Let it reduce a little bit more.
Let's check on the gem.
It's getting more solid. It's getting more solid. Yes. I want it to be a little bit more solid than this. Definitely a pound less sugar. But still very good. This thing go. Can you see it? What's this called? Gurgling. For I don't know how many decades I've been calling it that. Look at that. Nice. Crazy sweet. We're gonna go blackberry picking later on, hopefully, if the season holds up, and we'll probably make more blackberry jam, hopefully, if we get enough. And if we do, what I'm gonna end up doing, most likely, maybe, we'll see what it's like after it cools down. Right now it's really sweet, right? What I would do is open up the jars after milling the next set, open up the jars and not add too much sugar in the next batch, and then mix them together and then jar them again, right? And that'll be the perfect sweetness. Okay. So if I end up making another batch of these, let's say if it was 8 pounds of blackberries, I would probably add 1 pound of sugar. Kick it down hardcore, right? Peace, Nicholas. Hope you have a fantastic Monday. Thanks for sticking around. Thanks for the laughs, man. It's the stream. But it's 1:30 a.m. here and I have work at 6 a.m. 6 a.m. Oh my god. Look at this thing go. Okay, time for jarring. Let's do. I'm gonna lay down something that we don't care if it gets seriously stained. Oh, we're gonna kick this down. Definitely kick it down. We don't want it to be boiling up too much. And remember, we have to keep tabs on make sure the jars don't crack, right?
Let's make sure the lids are okay. It's hot. Yeah, the lids are steaming. I'm not sure if you can see the steam coming off. Okay. And let's bring out the jars. And as before, jarring, don't forget your mittens. You're gonna need them. You're gonna need them. And what am I gonna do? I'm gonna bring this over a little bit here so you guys can see. Actually, I can adjust this. Here, let me do a little adjustment here. That way you see what's going on. To listen for the sound, right? And we're going to pour it in gentle. Sky. Bring this guy over. Put it on. Okay. Let's put this guy here. Nice. Bring these guys. Okay. And what we're going to do is not too tight. And when I put it over there, I'm just putting the towel on top of it. Okay. We're going to do another one. Let's give this a spin. Let's make a 250 one. Now these guys are gonna have to pour slow. Okay. Really slow. Otherwise it's gonna crack.
you gotta do is wipe off the top, right? Because that way there's nothing stuck between the lid and the glass jar. Come on. Chicho, your permission is needed. What's the permission, Lions? We're just a chat room for crookles. And incidentally, grab full of boiling jam. Lions, what's the permission you guys need? They want to name the Discord Chicho's Jar Gurgles. Spot of tea. For sure. Whatever you guys feel like, man. Can we name the Discord Chicho's Gurgles? Done deal, man. You got my permission. For sure. That cracks me up. Chicho's Gurgles. Too funny. That's funny. And we acquired the name on August 12th, 2019, during a blackberry jam making session. That's for trivia. That's cool. Admin, do your thing. Nice, we're getting a nice supply of jam. That's good. I didn't think we were gonna get this much jam, but I think the amount of sugar we added might have increased the volume a little bit. More jam. We only have 500 mil jars left. I didn't heat up too many 250 mil jars. I'm gonna kick down the temperature in the oven a little bit. I'm gonna kick it down to 275. Okay. Thank you. don't want them to crack. It's the name of the server for now. That's cool. You don't want to pour too fast, otherwise the jar will crack. You definitely don't want it to crack. Did you hear one of them go boop, sealed up? That's good. Let's have a sip of matcha. Yeah, the pouring sound is amazing. I love it. Let's move this guy over a little bit so it's not sitting on the spilled jam. I'm kicking this guy down, the temperature down to like low, right? It's right at the bottom. I don't want the bottom to burn. And we really don't need it that hot anymore, right? We still have to maintain the temperature. Oh, did you hear that? That's a crack, crack, crack. That glass broke, right? And that is the frightening sound when pouring the jam, right? I'm gonna turn off the oven as well. The pouring sound is amazing, the sizzling, right? But then it goes, and if it's gonna crack, it cracks at the beginning. So pour slow at first, let the heat distribute. Yeah, right there. Let me see if I can show it to you guys. Hopefully it won't break. See the crack there? See that guy? So we need to put this somewhere safe. We need to put this somewhere safe. I'm gonna put this guy, and no matter where, when the jar breaks, whatever jam is in there, it's sacrificed. It's done. Do not eat that, right? Do not, like, it's not worth it. Okay, let's put this guy here. Okay, we'll bring out the next one. We should be able to fill one more at least. Let's see. We're gonna pour slow. there goes another one sealing. That's the good sound. That's the amazing sound. So we ended up getting 6. We ended up getting 6 500 mil and 3 275 mil. Okay, and this guy I'm going to transfer over. Here, let me put this guy over. I'm going to pour this guy into a bowl because we're just going to eat it. Here's our phone, by the way. This guy's off. Let's pour this in here. We need the spatula. See that? See this guy? Concentrated. Actually, I could just use this. Look at this guy. Look at the gookiness of it, right? Nice. Nice. There goes another sealed one. You gotta do this fast, otherwise it just hardens. And then you can't scrape it off without damaging the pot. All you can do is just pour hot water over it, right? There goes another one. They're sealing up really nicely. Take a look. Unfortunate that I made it so sweet. Okay, I should have listened to you guys. I'm gonna eat the one on the cloth as well. Look at this. I should have a pound less sugar. Minimum. But very delicious. Delicious blackberries. I'm gonna put this guy here. Let me pour this foam. Actually, I can do the water on this later. Is this hot? I don't want it to burn. So let's do this. Hold on. Let me put this guy here. Let's open this guy. Let's just put it in. Let me soak this stuff up here. just gonna do the wash later. I just wanna get clear off this space right now and just get the sugar sorted out. Cool. That way it just doesn't stick to the pots. So we can turn this off, turn that. The tea's okay to go. Let that go. And that's what we got. We got blackberry jam. Where's let's bring that another little spatula. Let's scrape this guy off. Oh, this goodness. And all of these things that... All of the stuff that we used up that has... It's all full of jam. Like these guys, like they look. Like this is all jammy. I'm just gonna put it in the hot water and just melt away. Huh? Cool. So the cleanup is relatively easy. Everything gets a little sticky, right? So that's what you have to deal with. It's a good texture on the jam. The sweetness, a little too sweet, for sure. I've been a Chicholian for over 3 years, Martin. I was there when the great chuckles arrived at the mountains. Knowledge and chit-chat. Fun. Delicious. I gotta get myself some sour cream and eat this stuff with sour cream. We could turn off this guy. This video. I think it's this one. Oh, wrong one. This one. Boink. And then these guys we can put away. This is our jam. We'll leave this here maybe. This guy needs a wash. You can move the camera down. Take a look. Take a look at this thing. Right? Now this is the scrape off the pot, right? So it's gonna be a little bit thicker. Well, it's gonna be a lot thicker. Or thicker anyway. Than the jam itself, most likely. I won't know how thick the thickness of the jam. Until I crack one of those jars open later on. But we have this to eat, and we have the foam to eat, all right? So we've got a couple of bowls to eat before, what was that, 7? That was a crack in the jar, was it? I don't think so. Usually the jars don't crack once you close them up. Okay. 2.5 hours. Oh, now I realize about the sugar. What about the sugar? Kieran, as one of the chief curclers, it's your duty to deter those with trifle with the Chicholian. Fun. 2.5 hours, that's not a bad streak. I did some research. The Chichonia ranking system is as follows. Kirkles, staff Kirkles, Kirkle, first class, master Kirkle, first Kirkle, Kirkle major, command Kirkle major, and Kirkle major of the Chichonian People's Army. Peace Army, man. I like that. That jab looks perfect. It's the texture is really good. The sweetness for sure. A little bit too sweet. I went a little bit too heavy. Initially the ratio was I was gonna put more. 2 more pounds. It would have been crazy, right? It's a good thing the blackberries were filling up the pot, right? So at least 1 pound less sugar for next time. So we put 4 pounds of sugar for 8 pounds of blackberries. I would go 3 pounds of sugar for 8 pounds of blackberries. If I'm going to mix up with these guys, probably two. Two would be good too. I think 2 pounds of sugar would be plenty. Okay. I think 2 pounds of sugar would be plenty. Fantastic. Fun stream, gang. The sing-along. I missed the sing-along. Oh, no. I missed the sing-along. Definitely fun stream. I'm glad you guys had fun. I'm glad you guys had fun. We've had two streams where it was a riot. Super fun. Can't believe you lot timed me out. Fail 33 of 11. What? Sugar less than overtime. Okay. Sugar less than overtime? I don't know. Usually does it get sweeter over time or less sweet? I don't know. I haven't thought of it on that level. But we'll keep track of it. And for sure, right now it tastes really sweet. It might blend in more so it's less sweet, but it's pretty sweet, man. It's pretty sweet. I think 4 pounds of sugar was a little too much. Sorry, thank you. Oh, we might have had some troll action going on. Mods, thanks for taking care of business. Seriously, appreciate it very much. Blasphemy, blasphemy. So in 2 days, we're going to do apples. And I'm going to post a picture of how much apples we have. Tomorrow, most likely, I'm going to cut up the apples. I might do it Wednesday morning and put them in the pots. Because they're basically apples that I picked when we were driving. It was in a field and someone had planted 4 different types of apple trees. And it's an open field, like no one's taking care of it, right? And because it's just an open field, some of the apples have worms in them and stuff like this. So I'm going to cut them up, throw away the wormy part. The rest of it is okay, right? And if we get any worms in there, it's just protein in the jam, right? Apples, but we won't. I'll make sure we don't get any worms in there. Oh, good. He got his last chance after all. Okay, so you guys gave people a warning. Good stuff, good stuff. No worries. Apple jam. Applesauce. So the sugar content on the apple... that we're going to make, applesauce we're going to make, is going to be way, way less, right? So the odds are we're going to go like, if it's 8 pounds of apples, we're going to put 1 pound of sugar, maybe 1.5 pounds of sugar, maybe 2, right? Not 4, maybe 2, okay? Because they are tart apples. So what I did after the blackberry picking, we were driving and we knew where these things are, because there's a area near me anyways, about a half 20 minute drive, where it's like full of blackberries. Like seriously, it's known as the blackberry center, right? So where people go blackberry picking, and there's different side rows that ripen at different times depending on how much sun they get. So we picked what we could, the blackberries we just cooked up. On the way home, we stopped by the 4 apple trees and I picked some apples. Should I bring and show it to you? Let me show it to you. They're heavy. So you got this. Okay. It's a fair bit. These ones are red apples. They're very good. They're tart, so it's gonna be really tart. Okay. Definitely not as long as the best, Chicho. Nah, I want apple pie. Apple pie would be amazing. So these are, like, look at this. From a field, right? Super delicious. Like, really, so good. Here's another one. Right? Here, take a look. Now, some of these have worms in them, like that. But you can eat it on the other side. So I need to cut these up. Super delicious. tart as well. And then there's green ones. Here's another worm. Alright. Just eat it on the other side. And there was another one that I didn't pick. This was enough. And we're not going to cook all this. I don't think so. Pretty good. Tart. These two guys have a stronger flavor. This is like a typical green apple. And it's got red in there too. I don't know what kind of apple these are. So I'm gonna cut these up tomorrow. I'll post pics on them tomorrow. I like them apples. Man, I knew I'd visit some Chicho Classics on YouTube. Fine. Chicho Classics on YouTube. I don't know which ones are considered to be classics. I'm pretending I still don't know how to read a textbook. Board Game Collection is a good one. Board Game Collection is good. I still need to make Video Game Collection. I was planning on, I had my posters out. I was gonna make a posters, showing you guys the posters collection and recording on a HD camera and stuff, but my editing computer is done. Right? I gotta wait until I can get that back up running again. Okay. I love them. Ah, thanks for the love, Spot up the. My first video was the first comic call. Oh, was it? The eBay, the first one we did, we got a lot of daredevils. That, Spotted Tea, that was a fantastic buy, right? I had no idea we were gonna go into a full-blown comic book playlist with, I don't know how many comic book videos we have, doing a haul, selling stuff on eBay, getting the, collecting the data, start doing mathematics on it, right? I had vision to sort of thought about it, because in the intro I mentioned this is something we could do. I'm glad it worked out where we've done so many readings, so many comic book hauls, and we sold some stuff and listings and talking about history and all that jazz. Fantastic. One of the great loves of my life. Glad to share it with you guys, man. Glad to share it with you guys. Fun. Okay, gang, let's call the stream. I'm gonna do a little bit of cleanup here. We had some splatter and stuff. I gotta wipe everything down so it's not sticky. I hope you enjoy it. I'll let you know how the jams are. If the sweetness goes down a little bit, I don't know if it will, Martin. Mine was a comic reading. The comic readings, man, fantastic. I can't believe those became popular and people really like them, because my pronunciation of names sucks. My reading is not the best. For me, when I was growing up, it was, I'd get like panic attacks. You know, teachers would get you to read in front of class or whatever. I didn't like it. So I'm glad I have broken through that barrier, personal obstacle, and it's been received so well. It's phenomenal, really. Thank you, Chicho. My pleasure. Thanks for the fun chat. Good times. Tight stream. Didn't think I'd make the whole thing. We'll try cash the next one too. Awesome, Casey. Thank you for taking care of it. And thank you for adding the names of whatever's being kept track of. Strongly, I was looking for Batman the cult and I found Chicho. Wow, that's cool. We still haven't done the Batman cult reading yet. We gotta do the Batman cult. We can't do the comic book readings yet. I gotta get that stuff sorted out, man. Cheers for the effort. Cheers. Kirkles. Okay, gang. Hope you guys have a fantastic Monday, and I'll see you guys in 2 days. And I think we're starting at 11 a.m. my time. I believe so. On a Wednesday, August 14th, I guess. August 14th. Okay. Thanks, everyone. And thank you, all the mods, for taking care of business. Sure, not blowing nice. I don't think so. Bye, everyone.